Hi there, I want to show you a few things you can do with StatCrunch that might help you with your project. If you would go to Explore, Data, look up a data set called Number of Credits. This is a data set I put together to help us illustrate some of the skills you might need to work with the data in your project. Now, this is not the data in your project, but it is a data set that has some similar characteristics to that of your data you have in your final project for the online section. Now, this data is comprised of a column called gender, which you can see here if I scroll down is male and then female. So all the males are listed first. There's 45 males and 45 females. Also, it has division, or you might think of as school. So these are students. It's a random sample of 90 students. And they have listed in a survey whether they were in the engineering school, business school, arts and sciences, health sciences, etc. And then also what they reported was the number of credits they were taking that semester that they took the survey. So these were all full-time students. You can see anywhere from 12 up to, I think I saw, a 19 credits there. So just so you're a little familiar with the data set, this is the one I'm going to illustrate some things. Now, suppose you'd like to find the mean number of credits that males were taking in each of these divisions or schools. Now, I would go to Stat, Summary Stat, because that's where I always get my means, medians, standard deviations, etc., columns. What we're going to work with now, which you haven't seen so far in the class, is the where and the group statement. So I'm going to build a statement in where I'm going to choose gender, add the column, so you'll see right up here it puts that in here, equals, and here are the different values that gender can take on, of course, are male and female, so I'm going to say male, add. So I had to add column to get gender. Once I chose male, I hit add as well. So I get this statement that says gender equals male. And I say, okay, so what's going to happen when we ask for this summary stats to be done is only going to do summary stats on the male students. Also, if I'd like to see this for the mean number of credit hours for each division, I have to group by division. So you have to set this where to gender equals male and group by division. Now if I hit compute, I'm not really worried about which ones. The default setting says quite a few summary stats here. This should be enough to see. We'll hit compute. Oops. Need to select your quantitative variable. Sorry. Credits. That's what we want to see, the mean number of credits. Now hit compute. What we see here are the different means number of credits for the 11 males that are in arts and sciences, the 9 males that are declared as business school, the 10 males that are in engineering, etc. And you can see the different means here. They all seem to hover somewhere around 14 credits. We also have the medians, standard deviations, etc. So you get a nice summary for those male students. If I hit options and edit, I can go back and I could build a different statement and I could erase, backspace, the male. And if I wanted to look at the same information for female, I just have to select that value, female, and add. Now you can see the expression says gender equals female. Hit OK. Now you see the statement's there, double check, and hit compute. And now I have information on the female students. It'll remind you up here what you set as the where statement and your group. So we have 8 women that were in the education division, and they take on average 14.125 credits. So you can see that. So it's a great way to work with data and be able to only look at certain individuals and possibly look within certain, in this case, values in this column, this categorical values here. So it's just a little hint there. It might help you with your project and doing some of the analysis you need.